Hello my friends, in this video I'm going to show you how we organize winter dormancy for our armadillo lizard or Ouroborus cataphractus. Most of you probably know them as Cardillus cataphractus, but Ouroborus is the latest version of their scientific name. So here how we organize our winter dormancy for this species. As you can see, we have six boxes. We don't organize wintering in their summer terrariums because we have no opportunity to control temperature in the room, as we need quite low figures of the temperature. We are grateful to our friends who gave us a lot of necessary information about wintering of this species. We move all breeding groups to their personal boxes. We don't separate the animals, so the group is placed in one box and put them on this shelf. And here is how we keep them during 2 months in this wintering room. This is the plastic box with the ventilation on the top. The ventilation is a metal net that is glued to the plastic. Let's open it and see how everything is organized. So we have a water dish that is always full of fresh water. We change it regularly. We have the amount of shelters that is equivalent to the number of animals inside the group. Here we have a group of one male and one female, so two shelters are present. And here we have them spending their wintering. I will not hold it for a very long time because my arms are very warm. I don't want the animal to get a temperature shock, but this is the male. Let's leave him. And this is a female. They are not as active as they used to be in summer when they warm up very well. And during this winter dormancy, they don't eat. We don't offer any food because if we do, they won't be able to digest it properly due to very low temperatures. Ambient temperature in the room is about plus 16 plus 18 degrees Celsius, and if it drops below these figures, so below plus 16 degrees Celsius, we have a special warming cable here inserted in the shelf. And if the temperature is very low, we switch on this cable and it allows the animals to warm up for 3 or 4 hours a day. Not more, because then we will spoil the wintering, but the animals will have opportunity to choose more comfortable temperatures. This method proved its effectiveness because this year we got 4 healthy and precious babies, and you saw them in one of our previous videos. And we hope that next year, in breeding season 2022, we will got more babies, of course. However, we know that, for example, these guys like to pour out all the water from the water dish. For some reason they do it regularly, and we remove the wet paper and change it also regularly. The animals don't do any other things here, and all we need is just to keep the temperature and to keep them moisturized enough. Here we have another group of one male and two females. The groups are well harmonized, and as you probably know, these animals are quite sociable and they need to be kept in groups. When we start to prepare them for the winter dormancy, we stop to feed them 2 or 3 weeks prior to switching off the light and prior to transferring them from our summer room to the winter room. We also reduce the lighting period slowly, so for 1, 2, or 3 hours per day, like to prepare them to make the temperature decrease more slightly, more more calm, so for the animals not to get the temperature shock, so not to transfer them from plus 30 to plus 16 degrees Celsius at once, because we don't want to harm them. And the process of wakening up is reversed to the process of preparing them for the winter dormancy. Then the groups are transferred back to their summer terrariums, and we spend some days waiting for them to copulate, and then wait for healthy babies from our females. I think that you enjoyed the video. I hope that you will subscribe to our YouTube channel, you will follow us on Facebook, and you will not get by the COVID-19 infection. So stay safe, stay with us, and have fun in 2022. Goodbye.